Chi-Town.
Chi-Town Urban Radio,
good, it's your girl KT Lace. I'm rocking with DJ Milan. Chi-Town Urban Radio.
Hey guys, this is Attila, ATTXLA, because X marks the spot all day, every day. And you are watching or listening to, depending on what you're doing, Chi-Town Urban Radio. Thank you.
Chi-Town Urban Radio.
Chi-Town Urban Radio.
You're on.
Yo.
Hold on.
I love when the beat drops.
Hold on. Yo, it's the one and only DJ Malone.
And your co-host, Ebony Thiel.
And you know what? We're in Houston, Texas, Chi-Town Urban Radio. I'm talking about energy in this motherfucker.
Lit.
Yeah, man, and who we got into the building, bro? We got a group into the building. What's going on?
The Archangel, Band of the Heart, Grynd.
Yes, sir. Okay, definitely, man. Welcome to the show.
You guys get home. Good to be here, man.
Welcome.
So let's go on the road real quick. Introduce yourself and what you do.
No Archangel, the Band of the Hawk. I'm the leader and main producer of the group and the crew.
Okay.
That's right.
I'm Breeze. I've been writing. Songwriter. Sing a little bit, rap.
Okay. All right, definitely. What about you, bro?
I'm SCX. I'm a thought spitter and a song creator.
Okay.
Yeah. It's Wall of Vader, man. I spit country rap too.
Country rap tune.
That's
a new one. I like that. Definitely, man. So,
what you do,
so let's break it down. How did you guys come a group?
Funny story. I was drinking with Sticks. You know, STX is pronounced Sticks, but I'm drinking with him. He's a bartender. A few years, and finally over some debating on hip hop or whatever, we found out we both make music, and then he came over, brought his boys over, and then the rest is history.
But it took so long, though.
Yeah.
Y'all knew each other for so long.
Yeah. About bottles.
Okay.
But
when
it finally happened. Ice and napkins.
Okay.
Yeah, you know, but you know what I'm saying? Love was there, and then whenever they came through the first time, they laid out a little something, and then brought a whole beta, and then again. So after that, I was like, we gotta keep doing this.
Real.
6 months later, we dropped the record that you guys know. So yeah.
Okay.
Right, yeah. You know what I mean?
All right, that's what it is. So how? Let me ask you guys this: how long did that record take to get out? To get it mixed, to get it mastered, how long was that record process?
Honestly, yo, really, most of the tracks were done maybe like in 2 months, three. It's just that they're perfectionists.
Yeah, yeah, we kept going back and tampering with it.
You know what I mean? Like, I'm more of
it gotta be right.
I'm more of a go in, get out kind of producer, you know what I mean? Mm-hmm. Someone from the 90s kind of cat. These cats, they like songs, they write songs.
Right.
So they was coming through and making sure they perfected it. So 6 months all together, they dropped the whole joint, and they still got like 10 bonus tracks to put out. So yeah.
And then, you know, it was just a new whole process, you know, with us all really being together and creating.
It's all love, man. You know what I mean?
Yeah. All right. That's what it is, man. Okay. So, is there roles for, you know, I know you're the producer, but is there like a person who has that? He's the leader, he's the overall
good
guy.
Good question, gentlemen. What is that? I don't know.
I kind of see.
I've been turning to you for everything.
You know, from the outside looking in as the producer, I would say that the leader, when it comes to kind of leading the songwriting aspect, is Breeze.
Yeah. Okay.
Breeze usually comes with a hook and a verse. He picks the beat.
Was a gun for hire. just pulling him at the trap.
I'm on him.
I'm just saying from what I see.
I'm on
him. Yeah, you know what I mean? So,
okay.
You know what I mean? But it's never been like sad. It's just kind of like, this is what's done.
Just a natural.
We just do how we feel. I mean, they spit ideas. I hear them say, hey, okay, here's what I can go with that. Or vice versa. I come at them with an idea that's like, oh, I hear that with this. And we just vibe off each other really well.
Okay. Yeah.
Well, that's good because, I mean, you get a lot of groups nowadays and you kind of look at past groups and it's like they designate a kind of, it's kind of just kind of like you designate a leader already because that's kind of how either the media is going to portray it or that's how it kind of seems. Yeah. So that's good that you all had to kind of work together and mesh as one and then you put input all together. So I think that's pretty cool.
That's all the way it's going to work.
Okay.
Definitely though, man. So what records you guys putting right now, man? What's the records you guys are doing?
Easy, which is really pronounced Ease.
Okay.
You know what I mean, that's the first single. Putting that out on all the social media, all the satellite radio and all that. It's getting some good spins and getting some good feedback. So, you know, but they got another one that's more underground that we were pushing before that, you know what I mean? But right now, Ease is what's really getting everybody kind of excited and whatnot.
All right. This is just a funny question. Maybe I'm just tweaking. Who gets the most females? I need to know.
You know, it's funny because I was going to say me. You know what I mean? This is Noah. We never, funny enough, seriously, brother. We never talk about that when we're in the studio. It's always like, all right,
there's so much work going on.
Who's got the better verse and all that? So it's funny, like,
The real question is, who got the game or not? Spit some at me, all three of y'all, and I'm going to be like, all right. We gonna have to do it when we come back. I wanna test it.
You wanna test that game?
Yeah, I'm gonna test the game. Since I'm female.
What would they win?
I mean, you don't.
I'm prize oriented person.
I don't know. Nothing. I didn't have anything in mind. I was just gonna pick
can't work
some,
for free.
What about a shout out? Whoever wins gets a shout out on the Instagram.
That's fair.
Cool.
That's fair.
Yeah, I can do that.
She has a good following. So, it's going to be a good situation. So, all right. So, Ease. Now, with the record. How is because I haven't heard it before. So when I hear it, this is my virgin ears. This is gonna be my virgin ears. No pun intended, because people think, oh, he never got fucked in his ears before. There's some freaky people out there.
It's a market.
It's Super Bowl weekend.
You ain't live like that if you ain't.
Take it back to like.
How is the track? Like if I'm listening to it, what am I expecting?
To me, man, it's got a groove, it's like an Afrobeat groove, kind of like a Rihanna Drake type thing. But you're talking about lyricists here, so they're gonna have a nice smooth flow over it. But it's got a nice groove to it, you know what I mean? So anybody that likes just a groove, you know, the reggae type Afrobeat, they'll like that, you know what I mean?
Okay.
So yeah, it wasn't intended. It was just something after when I sampled the record, it just kind of happened that way.
Okay.
Yeah.
Definitely. Okay, that's what it is. You wanna go ahead and break the record?
Sure thing.
Let's go ahead and break the record. You guys wanna introduce the record?
Yeah. So y'all go ahead and listen up, man. Y'all about to hear this new single we got pushing. Easy. Prepare your ears. Get ready for it.
We're about to get it live. South Channel Number Radio with the one and only DJ Malone.
And your girl Ebony Kiara.
Let go.
Pull up, sleeves on freeze. Something on D's. It's something that I need at ease.
Jam to Chi-Town Urban Radio.
You can see over the trees.
I'm so cool that it's tough to keep warm. Maybe it's the charm. No, I try to clock it.
Yo, it's the one and only DJ Malone, man.
And your girl Ebony Kiara.
And man, we still here with Noah and the crew, man. What's going on?
Ryan Seazon.
Y'all ain't live enough for
me. Yeah, man. Yeah, man. We been turning up all day. That's why we like this.
That's what it is. That's what it is.
Yeah.
Okay, that's what it is then, man. So let me ask you. Let me turn the music down, because I really need you guys to understand what I'm about to say right now. When you guys blow up, will you forget about me?
No.
Okay.
You're the first DJ that's interviewed us in Harlem City.
So you
officially.
I'm not even from this city.
Exactly. Now you understand what I'm saying. You know?
Definitely. Yeah.
So, that's a beautiful thing.
Okay.
Right there,
okay.
Love is love, man. At the end of the day, man, energy can't be destroyed. So when we get good energy, we always make sure we get it back. So
real.
So the same question goes for you. Will you forget about us?
Yeah. I don't never forget about nobody. I don't never.
That's
as long as you keep in contact with me, we good, man. We good. So, next 3 years, where you hope to see yourself?
Hopefully, headlining South by Southwest.
Ooh.
Nice. Like that. You know, you're
overseas. You know I need to get over there.
We're trying to do the Wu-Tang thing in Texas, you know what I mean? Like, okay. So at the end of the day, I feel like, yeah, headlining South by Southwest, European tours, you know, being behind, maybe, you know, opening for somebody else bigger, you know, a legend. Not like an up-and-coming guy, but a legend or something like that. But, you know, this is lifetime. This is love of labor. This is not about money, man. So it's like, I'm going to do this regardless of you remember me or not.
I mean, you will remember, but regardless.
Yeah. Okay. Thanks for that point.
Do me a favor. Tell my assistant, the girl with the Texans, that somebody's at the door. No, not you. You know, you guys stay
you guys
here.
I'll get up. Like, I'm like, no, not you guys.
Teamwork. Yeah.
So we here, man. Sidetown of a radio. We're having a good time. So, who'd you guys like to work with, producer wise? Besides, I'm not knocking you.
Besides my man's in there, man. You know what I'm saying?
Y'all better answer this question right. I'm telling you.
But who would you guys like to work with, producer wise?
This is just like a one time thing. I want to be from a producer, so I need him.
It's. Let's say it's the dream. Let's say this is the guy that you've been waiting for.
Nice.
Okay. Nice. Why?
Why? Yeah, I was just going to say why.
I don't know. It's always weird. It's always been weird.
He's the godfather, man.
Okay. Yeah, not to mention.
Godfather, boom,
godfather, man. Won't be no Dilla without him.
Always imitated, never
do. And Dilla's definitely, if not the best, second producer.
Okay.
I can't think of anybody better.
I will. What about Wonder? What about Ninth Wonder?
You know, Ninth came from the school with Q-Tip and Jay Dilla.
It's like all in the same.
Yeah, when I go to the duplication, when I can go to the original. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Ninth Wonder, though.
Ninth Wonder's definitely a beast.
He's the man. I'm gonna go to Q-Tip and Jay Dilla first.
Real.
Yeah. Okay. That was a great answer, G. Yeah.
I like that, though. So, Ebony, are you ready to play this game?
I am.
Wait, they don't get the answer?
Right, you didn't get the rest of the answer from everybody.
Well, who would you?
I'm not even. I mean, if it was up to me, it's going to be my
this is the
my
dream,
cousin.
Bro. This is the end all, the major hill. This is the one.
I mean, if I go into the bag of dreams of Vader, I probably will pull out my cousin, man. My cousin grew the funky drummer. Like, he's the dopest drummer I've ever seen.
Okay.
And that a lot of people haven't seen yet.
Young girl.
So,
shout out.
I mean, he used to be a producer. He used to be on the track. So, I mean, you get some live drumming from him, and then have him actually create everything that he wants his sound to come out. That'd be ideal for me. Like that'd be perfect.
Yeah.
That'd be perfect.
What about you, bro? What about you?
Forever now, man. I've Swiss Beats, man.
Okay.
What's up, Swiss?
Okay.
I was in high school. That's when I even started making, you know, tracks. Swiss was the man. I got out. I'm rapping. I'm still thinking of, you know, Swiss joints. Just, you know, it usually was fun on the track.
Real Swiss.
On there. He might be talking, screaming, even trying to rap. Whatever you're doing, but it's fun. I feel like them niggas in there having so much fun that. You can't lose.
Yeah.
It's gonna be tight, and we gonna.
The energy's there.
Yeah.
Okay. Let me before we go into the game. Let me ask you this: as a producer,
yes.
Put yourself aside for a second. As a producer, you had to co-produce with somebody. Who is in that lab with you?
Oh, RZA, no doubt.
Okay.
Wu-Tang forever today with me, man.
Okay.
I spoke off the school Wu-Tang. Yeah.
Definitely. RZA. Okay. Well, let me give you a little twist to it. All right.
RZA's
not there. All
right.
Dre's not there.
Okay.
Who is there?
DJ Primo. What? Give it to me. Give me for 500, Alex. Give it to me.
Okay, definitely, man. So, are you ready to play this game?
I'm ready.
Oh, man.
I'm going to make it easy. I'm not going to even be extra like I normally am, and I'm not going to make it hard. So, I hate to use me as an example, but okay. So, if you just seen me walking, just down the street, regular.
I've never seen you walk. Could you walk?
Oh, well, I gotta.
Oh,
I've never seen it. My visual's not that good.
Twist of the game. I didn't even think I was.
You know what?
You know what? You know what? Look,
I want to make sure my mind is right. I'm in the game. You know.
I gotta get up and walk.
Man, I guess you can.
Right. Just stand.
I'm gonna walk. I'm gonna do a spin.
Okay.
I don't really have any area to walk.
I'll take what I can get.
I'll do a spin.
There we go. She's standing up right now. All
right. All right. I see it.
It feels so wrong.
It's official.
Just in case y'all didn't know.
Okay.
So, I'll do a spin. Mm-hmm.
Oh, y'all missing it, y'all.
Okay.
Y'all just missed it.
Okay, I'm ready. What's the scenario?
It was off the chain, right, y'all.
So, walking down the street, got my bag of groceries, all that. I'm about to walk into my apartment. If y'all see me, what would you say? What would you do? Go.
I mean, me personally.
It doesn't matter who goes. Go first.
Me personally, I don't think I would walk up to a chick carrying grocery bags and try to speak
game
to
her. That's kind of creepy.
I mean, yeah, it is. I mean, I'd probably help her with the bags, but I don't think I'm going to try to...
You're on the first floor or the second floor?
I'm going to tell you the reason why.
You're on the first floor.
He's the dark skin. They're not going to let him in the house.
That probably won't. Get your ass in the field.
For his answer, I'm gonna switch it. Let's say I'm like putting the bags in my car.
Okay.
Instead of in my apartment, because it's kind of creepy. So we're gonna go. Let's say I'm like loading bags into my car.
Man, I was already at the apartment. Now I'm back at the car again.
What he said made sense. So it's creepy, right? So what he said made sense. Because I would probably treat somebody if they would do that in real life. So yeah. So let's just say I'm like loading bags into the car. How would you approach the situation? What would you say to make me give you my number? Like, how would you seal the deal? And go.
Man, that's tough, man. That's what's real tough. When we say, excuse me, miss, introduce myself to you. Actually, if you need help with your bags, my name's Noah. You know, at the end of the day, feeling y'all like how you look, what you got going on with yourself, and at the end of the day, I'm going to take you out to dinner. It's not that hard, man. I mean, I don't have game. I just be myself, so, yeah.
Yeah, that's pretty much, yeah.
Just conversate.
Yeah, you know what I mean? If you can't talk to me, then I'll be like, yeah, maybe this is a bad idea.
Yeah, I might not need to give you my number.
You know, you talk to each other, you know? So that's me. I don't know about y'all. Can't take my same answer. Y'all got to do something different. I went automatically.
Right, y'all agreeing. Everybody got to give a different answer,
yeah,
so
fine. That's why I said it first.
That's why you stepped up to the plate.
Hey.
Let me get this shit out the way real quick.
If it's not first, you'll...
But I mean, yeah, it's gonna pretty much be the same approach. You know, I'm gonna see you putting the groceries inside the car. I'm gonna,
that,
you know,
sounds
be
creepy.
Like, hey.
Damn.
Yeah, dude, though.
I mean, I'm not knocking it. It just sounds like I'm watching you.
Time out. But
you know what?
Dudes are creepy, though.
We said that. That was the same exact thing.
We got to accept
that.
That was the realest shit I heard today.
You know what I'm saying? And that's what they love. You know what I'm saying? A woman loves a man. If you know what you are and you can accept that, that's what she loves. So, I mean, you got to come.
Okay, the game got messed up because no one's actually really saying what you would actually say. And, like, putting you in the, you know. But we did just talk about this. So, I was, where was I again? La Roche today? LaRue, whatever you say this.
Okay.
LaRue. Right. So they had free crawfish, and I'm like eating the crawfish, whatever, fine.
You don't mess.
I'm knowing someone's watching me. I finish the crawfish, whatever, and dude's like, you know, dang, you made that crawfish look good. Now I want some. I never even had that, and I'm just like,
see?
So you were watching me this whole time eating this crawfish? I felt kind of weird. So why would you say that after the fact? So
and what did
yeah,
this guy? What? No, wait. What does this guy look like?
I don't remember, to be totally honest.
That's why. If he looked like something she remembered, totally different scenario.
If
it was Idris Elba, it wouldn't have mattered what he said.
Exactly.
Oh, my God.
Exactly. He could have tripped and tumbled.
Fatality.
That's just how it goes. That's how it go right there.
I'm not going to lie, that could have went a different way if it was like
exactly.
Idris Elba or something.
Exactly.
But so I mean, no, but in the same sense, I still would have thought about it if it was Idris Elba. I'm like, dang, you know, he's kind of watching me, dude. It's kind of gross. And I probably would have ate a little bit cuter, you know. I'm just like, P.O.P. You know.
We like to
preserve
y'all natural habitat. Just be.
No, I don't care. I'll eat in front of whoever.
Shark Week.
I'll
eat
in front of whoever, wherever, whenever, whatever. I like to eat, so I don't care who I eat in front of. It can really make a difference.
Okay. All right. So did you get the answer you were looking for?
No, they didn't give the game. All right,
let's do this. You're on the first date.
There we go. So I'm in there already. Yeah. So I'm making
it. Oh my god.
Fatality.
Okay. I guess you're in there like swimwear, I guess.
Woo.
So.
It's too close in there.
Woo. Okay.
And then like somewhere.
Alright. If what are you doing on the first date with her? Where are you taking her?
This is a better game.
What are you doing?
I'm gonna let them go first because I know they're gonna try to steal my answer, so I'm gonna let them go first.
I'm trying to steal your
own. you know how I do.
Well,
I mean, I'm definitely an old fashioned dude. I like movies a lot, so it's probably gonna be done in the movie. The movie's probably gonna be something super weird. So, I mean, it's probably gonna be an experience shoot. Remember, it is something basic, but I'll probably try to keep it a little fresh.
Okay. Even with that, man, that's just like, it had to come from a conversation, depending on what she like. If she like, you know what I'm saying, outdoor, go-karts, video games, that type of stuff. Or if she want to like do some artsy stuff, we can go to a museum. It just depend on, you know, what she into.
Museum, everything.
Or we can do all of them. You know what I'm saying? We can do all of them.
We're back in 2-2.
Ever since I saw the twirler out, I'm in the game, bro. Like, I'm in
so
the game.
What? What did you say?
So, contestant has been eliminated. Huh? Contestant A and B has been eliminated.
I mean, I don't even know who the contestants are. I don't.
Yeah, of course. Well, hi, Daryl. You got your answer from earlier. Who gets the most chicks?
Okay. What about you, man?
I'm an outside dude. I love to be outdoors. So probably would grab something to drink and then Discover Grynd. Not now, because Discover Grynd's packed as hell right now.
Yeah,
but
no,
on
yeah.
a typical night, maybe a couple Pokemon Goers out there. That's not bad. We can
Pokemon
get some
Go.
Drinks and walk through there. Because they always up at Discover Grynd. You can
always.
See the Pokemon Goers. You ain't
Pokemon.
You
don't.
You
know.
No.
I
don't. Yeah, you gonna see.
I don't do
it.
I know what it is.
Pokemon. You gotta catch them all, man. It's universal. It's gonna change the world.
Okay. Okay. Definitely. What about you, man?
Thank you.
It's simple, man. When women like to eat, so I'm gonna take it to like Boiling Crab or like LA Fisherman real quick, because that's kind of like it's a casual, upscale meal. So it's gonna make you get dirty and you're gonna talk. After we talk, we're going to figure out what we're going to do. Usually, it's going to either be, to me, Dave and Buster's, which is playing games, which is going to loosen you up again. Or we're going to go to do that indoor skydiving. Because that also, I want to try to get anybody out of their zone. Because at the end of the day, when you're out of your zone, you can't lie.
Really?
It's kind of like after the end of the 90 days, like you got to be yourself. Like, so when you're playing games or when you're doing something you're not comfortable with, you kind of be yourself. So you got an attitude. I'm like, all right, she's an attitude woman. And if she's having a good time, then she's a good time.
How old are you, man?
37, G. There you go.
Like you.
Damn. Oh, that's not my words.
Nothing.
Y'all boys weak.
No one.
Okay, Ebony, who you got?
Don't be influenced by the outsiders.
Right. Mike's Jeopardy is happening. Okay, wait. I'm going to narrow it down between these two, only because he said that he has to figure out. You have to figure out what somebody likes, but you can't just like put me in a situation and be like, all right, do this and that.
It's about you, whatever you want
to
do.
So I'm like, okay, he took the time out to be like, all right, I'm going to think about what she likes. And then.
I'm in the game, coach.
You wanna do, baby.
Coach put me in.
And then he said my favorite thing is food. So I'm
like,
dang. So I was like, food and games. I'm like, and.
You can't go wrong.
So.
Is it the muscle?
Yeah.
If you can put all of y'all answers into like one person, that'd have been a dope. Like, that would be done. Yeah. All
right, so we're coming down to the nitty gritty.
Yes.
And I want to ask you guys this before you go.
Mm-hmm.
Can I get a drop?
Oh yeah, from Shout Out Urban Radio.
Yeah, man, I love drops.
Yeah.
They make me happy.
Yeah.
That means that more people will tune in to me.
just Shout Out Urban Radio. That's it.
Don't pay attention to the Sasquatch in the building.
Yeah, I want
to
know.
You know what? Because that's Tom Brady, people. That's one of his loose ends. When I say loose ends, that's like the six nod right there that he did this tonight.
Yeah.
Damn.
Anyways.
Before you do the drop, wait.
Cut that one off. Anyway.
Before you do the drop, who y'all got on the Super Bowl?
Man.
Oh no! Okay, everybody's like, man.
Why are everybody going for the goddamn Falcons?
You know what
because
the
it's like, new. It's Atlanta.
You get tired of seeing them win.
God,
well, what
Jesus.
It is, I think Vegas knows that everybody's going to think the Pats are going to kill them. So Vegas, they hope you put your money on the Pats so the Falcons can win and they can get your money.
Real.
So being honest, man, you got to go. You know, it's like when the Saints won.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Like, so I'm just going off. I'm going off Vegas.
I feel like Atlanta need it.
They do.
Fire it up.
Just like the Cubs need
Exactly. Cubs need to win in Chicago. I think Atlanta needs this, and their city will be lit up for the rest of the year.
Okay.
Everybody's from Atlanta. Kendrick from Atlanta.
Every event would be red carpet in Atlanta if they win. So I think Atlanta should get it.
You know how much money a stripper is going to make?
Man, they're going to make 50,000
gajillion. And let me say, I personally don't care who wins. Honestly, I'm unfortunately a 49ers fan.
Oh, unfortunately.
Yeah. But I mean, I have a lot of loyalty, so I don't come switching teams when boys start losing.
Okay.
I just wanted to say that. I'm sorry.
No, you're good. You're good, bro. Get your interview.
Shouts out to the Texans, though. You know where we at, though.
All
right.
Yeah.
Shut up.
It's always the home team. First up.
Get your ass out of my studio.
I don't want to hear that.
Anyways, back to what I was saying. Before I was so rudely interrupted by blah.
All
right. Can you guys do the drop for me, man?
You want us to kind of like sound off, and then we'll say boom, boom, boom. We're listening to Chi-Town over radio.
Yeah, yeah. All right.
So I'm gonna say New Archangel Band of the Hawk. Y'all say yours, and then we'll say we're listening to Chi-Town over radio. You ready? All right. So whenever you're ready.
All right, man. Hold on.
Fatality.
You ready?
Yes, sir.
And go.
This is New Archangel from the Band of the Hawk.
Yo, grind season in here.
What are we supposed to go like?
That's it.
And you're listening to Chi-Town over radio.
Shout out to Radio, baby. Take two. Let's do this again. I'm glad we're recording.
Like that sounds like some boy band type of shit. Grind season.
Word.
Noah. Grind season. Somebody say it. First one.
Person saying grind season.
Whoever say it first.
You. It's me and you. Just me. Hey, don't worry about them. Me and you. Noah Archangel Band of Hawk. Grind season. Boom. Shout out to Radio. Ready? Let's go.
All right. 3, 2, 1.
This is Noah Archangel from Band of the Hawk.
Yeah, you got grind season kicking it in here.
And you listening to Chi-Town
over radio.
Yes, what's up?
Yes, sir.
Can I get a clap real quick for everybody?
Yeah.
That's what I'm talking about. Hey, Spot. Man, I appreciate you guys stopping through. Before you go, give
appreciate
a break.
Appreciate the love.
Oh, yeah. You good, man. You good people here.
Bless you.
That is a very petite sneaker.
You sound like a mouse.
It sounds like something I could wake up to, though.
Thank you for the compliment on the sneeze.
That's what they kind of sounded like.
I can't
even. give the Facebook, the Twitter, everything where they can find you, man.
Twitter, Facebook, Instagram, also at Noah of HTX. You know, these brothers don't like anything social media, so they kind
of. We're going to get on it, though. We're going to get on it.
So at Noah of HTX, bandofthehawk.com, holler at us, man. Everything you want. You got free music videos all there. You know what I'm saying? We make clothes, all that. You know what I mean? Everything hip hop.
A lot of dope music coming. A lot of dope music.
When's the next project coming out?
No clue.
Y'all got an album in the chamber. We're probably not gonna drop it till maybe next fall because they just dropped their last one, fall winter. We gotta let people kind of catch up to this before we drop another one. So you know what I mean. So I'm thinking like fall, but we got other things in between, and we got a whole cruise.
What are you doing for the summertime?
Summertime will probably be an instrumental and slash compilation record that I put out. I always put out a record to kind of showcase everybody that's on the Band of the Hawk.
Real.
Just you know, like I said, I mean, it's this grind season, this Band of the Hawk. There's plenty of other artists. You know, we need some more singers. If you a singer that want to work, holler at me.
Please.
Yeah.
I can sing.
Yeah, man. Shout out to King.
I don't
think
I'm this brother.
I don't think. I'm
you know me.
Yeah.
Shut up.
Yeah. Right.
Fatality.
What a party it's
been,
y'all.
Oh, my God.
Everywhere.
What a party it's been.
It depends on what you want to spend. Erica's at the Mosaic Lounge. Yeah, Erica produced the Mosaic Lounge. That's what I'm trying to head up to.
How much is the ticket?
Everything's like 50. You know what I mean? Yeah, so we heading over to Dave and Buster's and then going to the deck to drink. I'm going to drink, you know, show these boys a little good time before we get back to the studio. And then, Prospects, though. We go to the deck next door, though, just because we like to be around people that like people.
Yeah, I ain't a big fan of Prospects.
I like to be seen, but I mean, I like to be around people, and then you can see.
I ain't a big fan of that place.
Which night you go to Prospects, too?
Shut up. I'll give you that. I completely agree with you.
Somebody let the strippers out here? Where the strippers at?
We love
speaking that boy language. Now he's speaking my language.
Oh, I did hear they closed V-Live. I was really excited about V-Live Houston and they're closed it.
Yeah.
So I'm kind
of. But I mean, it's a lot of dope spots in Houston.
We'll probably be at Onyx at 5 in the morning, you know what I mean? But you know.
Yeah, you still got the studio's not popping.
I heard a G5 tonight. T.I. is going to be there or something like that. No G5? No?
Not me. I mean, you know, it's kind of like, I mean, it's fleeting. Just like V-Live is. It's kind of fleeting. Like, if you're going to, if I'm going to go anywhere, I'm going to go somewhere that's already been vetted. Like I said, Onyx is always a no brainer.
Dreams. That's why I heard a lot of people said they was going.
I don't know. Did Drake's Ballet open? Anybody hear about that? The ballet.
Hey, I don't know shit about strip clubs. I'm just.
I heard about the ballet too. I just don't know where it is.
Because I'm not a part of the conversation. Then I'm just gonna let people know why.
Okay. Super Bowl. You don't care about strippers. Yo, man, what's going down?
Exit stage left.
All right. Well. Hey, man. I appreciate you guys coming in, supporting, man.
Yeah.
Hey,
appreciate man. Appreciate you, brother.
Man, look. Tomorrow, man, Super Bowl. Stay safe.
Word,
you know, don't do anything crazy, because if you get locked up, you're not getting out till at least Thursday.
Yes, sir.
Thursday.
Yeah, and you, yep, and your daddy would know, huh?
Yep,
yep, I know he does. Her daddy beat my ass. She sent her, when I was in jail. She sent her daddy in there to beat the fuck out of me, man.
Can you say that?
Wait, that's did he commit a crime to
can
go?
You say that?
That's yeah. Thank you,
thank you. He was looking too good.
I got to get him.
It is a crime these days. Look so good, you know what I'm saying?
Oh,
nah, I do.
This is 8 years ago, and he's still harboring on it. Let it go.
It's tough, man.
I don't know, man. I came to Houston to come check her out, and I get locked up for something I didn't do. I get locked up for trying to attempt the murder when she slapped me. She slapped me in the elevator when we were coming up here. I had witnesses.
Sound like Jay-Z and
I have witnesses.
You got Solange or the Ray Rice?
I got a bald head.
This boy weak.
I got. he was scared.
He was like, Beyonce.
Aaron about thought it was about to go down.
You were the Beyonce in the situation. You just watched. Man. Oh, okay. Gotcha.
Hey, man, I appreciate you guys coming through.
Our pleasure, brother. Appreciate you, Malone.
Hey, it's the one and only DJ Malone.
Your girl, Shout Ebony Kiara. Radio.
Man, we're going to come right back. Let go.
Seazon.
Oh, DJ Malone. This a banger.
This shit, you can't spin the check and get it right back. 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 Spin the check and get it right